then open up the door. I'll get them myself. Do you hear me? I don't want nobody to give me nothing. Open up the door. I'll get them myself. I don't give me integration. Give me true communication. I don't give me sorrow. I want equal opportunity to live tomorrow. Give me schools and give me better books so I can read about myself and gain my truer looks. I don't want nobody to give me nothing. Open up the door, I'll get it myself. Do you hear me now? Nah, I don't want nobody to give me nothing. Open up the door, I'll get it myself.
And America is finding its conscience.
Yes.
I visited Zuccotti Park in the first week of October, and I can tell you, I spoke to a lot of people there, and they all told me the same thing, that we are not protesters, we are occupiers. And that's a really important point. Mainstream media and those who oppose Occupy Wall Street would like nothing better than to define us. This movement cannot and will not be defined by one issue alone. As soon as specific demands are made public, that is when they will pounce and denounce. Again, this is not a protest, this is a movement. Right now, at this time, we are an occupation. Nothing more, nothing less. And again, the media and the American public have some idea of what happened this month, but I can tell you the wheels of Washington definitely have not. Senate Republicans just blocked the president's bill to create millions of jobs because it asked millionaires to pay their fair share in tax. And the Congressional Super Committee is still racing towards a deal likely to include big cuts to Social Security and Medicare without asking the rich to pay their fair share. That just ain't right. We have only weeks to stop it. So tell your co-workers, your neighbors, and your friends to get off their duff and get into the streets and tell anyone who's going to listen and say, I'm not going to take it anymore.
I'm not going to take it anymore.
Okay, for your union activists in the crowd who straddle the world of politics, obviously, if you're so inclined, you should be targeting the Republicans and Governor Cuomo, who are standing with Wall Street. Moreover, we need to keep the pressure on Democrats to push for more jobs and to tax the rich fairly, especially here in New York State. At the end of the year, a surcharge on the wealthiest New Yorkers will expire, meaning $5 billion of less public money that will be available for necessary public services like the stuff I do two blocks away at the Rochester Public Library. Cuomo said he is for the occupiers on Wall Street, but against the surcharge against the wealthiest of New York. Now look, Governor Cuomo, you can't have it both ways. You are entitled to your opinion, but you're not entitled to the facts. That doesn't how the math works. People who are wealthy in New York stay in New York. We have 10% more people than we have in New York since we started fair share reform back in 2009 when we stood on these damn steps here trying to get that damn thing passed. On behalf of all my brothers of CSCA, I just want to thank everyone again for coming here today. And again, this is a movement. It's not a protest. We're in it for the long haul. God bless those people who are putting their life on the line and putting their selves at risk for occupying wherever they are in this world. God bless.
Opportunity to live tomorrow.